Greetings, saints. Welcome once more this Sunday. He's God that is above everything. We need to praise him. We need to honor him. We need to appreciate him. Can we bow our heads and pray for the word today? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come into the throne of grace, O God. Lord, we humble ourselves before the throne of grace. And we say, Lord, we are here today, O God, to hear the word of God. Father, I pray that, Lord, you will be with me as I minister the word. Father, and separate my wish, my thoughts from the word of God, O God, today. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that, Father, even those that are supposed to receive this word, Father, I pray that their hearts will be ready to receive from the throne of grace today. In Jesus' precious mighty name, I pray. Amen. Today, I want us to talk under the topic, the name Jesus, the name Jesus, the name Jesus. I will read in the book of Philippians 2, chapter 2, verse 9 up until 11. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Every knee shall bow in heaven, on earth, and under. I want us to talk under this name Jesus, and a lot of people say this word in vain, or maybe you are injured, you just say, hey Jesus, and you don't understand the power that the name holds. And the word of God here is telling us in the book of Philippians 2 that this name was entrusted. It was presented to him as an honor. It was presented to him as a tool. So this name was not just given. This name is not like my name when you say faith. This name is not like your name when you say whatever name that you may have. But this name has been entrusted, has been highly exalted, has highly exalted him and bestowed him the name that is above every other name. This name is above every other name. And at the sound of his name, at the sound of his name, every knee will bow. At the sound of his name, every knee will bow. And I think what a lot of people, I just want to give a scenario. The name Jesus is like when you are carrying an AK-47, a rifle, a strong one. I don't know. I know AK-47. I think there are stronger ones. And if there are stronger ones, maybe we can say a bomb or anything that is of massive destruction that can do a lot of things. What a small little thing that you can just say the name of Jesus, but it can do a huge thing. But when you say it, it doesn't feel any weight, but it carries weight that we don't know, because we've got this thing like this bomb or this AK-47 that you are holding, but you don't know how to use it. And it's like, for instance, you take this machine gun, you take this AK-47, you give it to a 2-year-old. That child will just hold that gun because of its massive, because they may not know where to press in order to execute anything that they need to execute the same way. So we carry this name as the children of God, but we don't understand the power that it carries. Hence, we cannot use it. You live a life of defeat, but you are carrying an AK-47 in your hands. You live a life of trouble, but you are carrying an AK-47 in your hands. This name, Jesus, is as powerful as I don't know how to put it, but we have it, but we just don't know how to use it. And the Bible is saying here, this name has been highly exalted above every other name. There is no name on earth and everywhere in the planet that can be mentioned that is higher than this name. And that's why you'll find that those who maybe in the past have experienced bad dreams, maybe you have experienced bad dreams and you are sleeping. Even if you don't know how to pray, you just say Jesus, you realize that those bad dreams, they disappear, they vanish. Why? Is it because you are too much of a Christian? No. It's because of the intention. When you call that name, you had an intention. When you call that name, you had hope. When you call that name, you had faith. So you carry this AK-47, even if you don't know how to use it, but you know that if I can just press somewhere here, I was told that I can just press somewhere here, the bullets will come out. The same. And what puzzles me is that what is the difference? What is the difference? So you realize that somebody can call the name of Jesus and nothing happens. And somebody can call the name of Jesus and something happens. And sometimes you realize that as you walk with God, the level of faith that you will have, the faith as small as a mustard seed can move the mountain. So faith is required to move into the name. So when you have got faith in the name, you start to move the mountain. When you have got faith in the name, you start to do exploit. When you have got faith in the name, you start healing the sick. When you have got faith in the name, you start doing the things that you will normally not do without the name. That is the difference. Faith as small as a mustard seed can move the mountain. And we learn here that at 10, it says that so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Every knee will bow. Should. The proper English is should. It's not will. It's not could. It's not should. It says should. So there's a force with the name. There's a force. Should. There's a must. Must. There's no option. At the sound of the name, just to mention Jesus, every knee has to bow. And guess where it has to bow? In heaven, on earth, under the earth. In heaven, on earth, and under the earth. Everything has to bow. So I'm here to challenge you and me as well. What is that situation that is troubling you so much? What is that situation that has defeated you for years, but you are carrying an AK-47? You are carrying this thing with you. You have been holding it with going to the malls. You go into your school. You go into any place that you can go, but you are holding this AK-47, but it's not working for you. You are holding a bomb, something that is of massive destruction. You are holding this name that is so powerful that this name can do exploit, can do wonders, can do a lot of things, but you don't know how to use it. The answer is in you. At the sound of his name, every knee, not some of the knee, every knee should. At the sound of the name, every knee should. And maybe the question is, what triggers the knees not to bow? What triggers the knee not to bow? And that is the question that you need to go into the throne of grace and say, Lord, I'm claiming my rights. I'm claiming my position. You say that in your word, that every knee should bow. You said in the word that as faith as small as a mustard seed can move the mountain. With the faith that I have, and if I call upon this name, my child shall be healed. If I call upon his name, I have to be delivered. If I call upon his name, my family will be restored. If I call upon his name, I will see things that I never saw before in my life. Every knee should bow. Every knee should bow at the name of Jesus. I'm here to pray with somebody today that is saying, I don't know this God. But I'm here to say, those that says you believe in God and your ancestors, but the word of God is clear here. Your ancestors should bow to him. So why praise something that has to bow to something? Why don't you praise something that is higher than your ancestors? Anything on earth should. Other people bow at your bosses. You bow at your leaders. You bow at people because you want favors. But the word of God is saying, even your leaders should bow. Every knee, not some of the knee. Every knee should. And I remember one time, there was this guy who needed leave when I was still managing that guy. And he said to me, there are people that are bewitching me here at work. And I want to take leave because I want to go to the Inyanga for the whole week. I want to take the whole week. And I said to him, I believe in God. I'm here at work. I can't tell you what you need to do, but I'll approve your leave. But I'm here to say, why bow to something when there's a higher power? It doesn't make sense to me. Why don't you go to the highest authority that is accessible? Why go to the lesser authority accessible instead of going to the highest authority that is accessible? Because any other authority has to bow. So if I'm struggling with certain authorities, if I'm struggling with certain power, why go to another power? Why don't you go to the highest power of the whole powers? Why don't you go to the powers which every power has to bow? This is the name of our daddy, our Christ, our Savior. He's accessible to any one of us. You have got AK-47 in your hands. You've got weapon of mass destruction in your hands. You just don't know how to use it at your favor. You don't know how to use it. And I'm here to say to you, somebody saying out there, I don't know this God. I want Christ. I've tried. I want, especially those that you have moved around, you know that you have tried. And I'm here to tell you, you have been trying in wrong places. There is power above every other power. There is power who is above every other power. His name is Jesus. You call upon his name. Every knee that has been troubling you has to bow at him, has to surrender to him. Every knee has to confess that indeed, we thought we've got power over this person, but actually we don't. There is power beyond our power. And I'm here to usher you to Christ today. You can follow me after this prayer and say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Forgive all my sins. Wash all my sins. I want to serve you from now moving forward. I believe that you died and you rose again. I believe that you are the Lord and you are the Savior. And from now, from today moving forward, your life will never be the same again. I can encourage you to say, wherever you are, if you are in any province, wherever you are, find a Bible-based church who believes in Jesus Christ as the only way to our Father. Then you will be safe in that environment. And pray that God will usher you into the right place. Father, I thank you. I glorify you, Lord, for this opportunity. Father, we belong to you, and everybody else beyond belongs to you. No one owns anyone. Father, we are taught here by the word in the book of Philippians that there is power in the name of Jesus. Every knee has to bow. There's somebody out there who says, I've been having challenges. I don't know what to do with it. I pray in agreement in their lives that that knee will bow on their behalf, oh God, and they will surrender that you are Christ on that situation, and surrender that this name Jesus is above every other name, and they will lose them. They will let them go. That child that has been sick, that elderly woman that has been sick, I pray that, Lord, at the sound of this name in their environment, wherever they are, as they hear the name Jesus, as I call it, let them be loosed, let them be freed, let them be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for families, I pray for children, I pray for health, oh God, in each and every person that is listening to this message in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Spirit of the living God, in Jesus' precious mighty name. Amen.